Well, church, here we are, one more week under our belts as we're doing church on the internet in lockdown. I don't know about you, but this might be starting to wear on you. And you're getting tired of being inside. You're getting tired of not being around each other. And you know what? I want to encourage you. That feeling is a good feeling. That desire to be with each other is a good thing. I don't like doing church on the internet. I don't like having Bible studies on the internet. I don't like having to be in contact with each other only through the internet. I want to see you. And that's a good feeling that we have. The more we love Christ, the more we love truth, the more we love those who Christ loves. That's what 1 John repeatedly tells us. If we know God, then we love. If we love God, then we love. So these are natural feelings that you have. So don't get too used to internet church. It's not the way God intended us to do it. But in the meantime, this is how we have to do things. So we've got different groups online. We've got church at facebook.com/Southwest Christian Church. We've got Bible study being done on Zoom. We've got Wednesday night studies, CUs. There's a whole list of things. So please make sure to look at that schedule that's in your email to make sure you know where you need to be. In the meantime, I'm convicted. And here's my conviction, is that we as a church, we need to care for one another. We need to be connected to one another. I think of last Sunday's sermon, talking about the royal law, which is to love your neighbor as yourself. And church, I really want you to take that to heart. It's not just me. I want you to take Christ's message to heart. So let's do that. Let's love one another. Let's not get too comfortable being by ourselves, all right? I look forward to being together. And church, I want to encourage you. I don't think this is going to go on forever. I don't think it's going to go on much longer. My goal and my goal is that we're back together again in the beginning of June. That's my goal. Beginning of June, we are together. We're going to have a great service together when that happens. I want us to have a nice breakfast. And I look forward to hearing you sing. No longer hoping you're singing at home. No longer hoping you're participating. But I want to see you. I want to hear you. I want to be in the same room as we even celebrate the Lord's Supper together. I'm looking forward to this. So look forward to it. So church, endure a few more weeks, okay? A few more weeks and we are together. I continue to ask that you be faithful in giving. The way you give is by either sending a check to the church. The mailing address is Southwest Christian Church, 28030 Dale Rio Road, Temecula, zip codes 92590. Or you can use Venmo and just with an app on your phone, digitally send your offering to the church. But we're grateful to those of you who continue doing that, and please continue to be faithful. And then the other thing I want to encourage you is maximize the time that you have together. Husbands, I'm speaking to you right now. Husbands, I want you to do me a favor this week, and that is take your wife on a date. Take her out on a date. And you're thinking, how am I supposed to take her on a date? We're stuck in the house. Take her on a date. Use one of those food delivery services, Grubhub or Uber Eats, one of those things, and order from a restaurant. We've got lots of great restaurants around here. Order a meal in. It's a little bit more money, but you probably haven't been going out to eat that much. Take your wife on a date, have a nice meal delivered to your house, whatever it is that your wife's favorite food, have it delivered. And then spend some time together. Don't just sit on the couch and watch a TV show, do something. Let me give you an example. Last Friday, Amanda and I, we had a date night at home. We made pretzels together, pretzels from scratch. Mine looked awful. Amanda's looked like pretzels. Mine looked like just piles of dough. And we made pretzels from scratch. We played some Jenga, and then we played a little conversation game where we would ask each other questions and learn some interesting things about each other. And we had a great date night together. So husbands, take your wives on a date. And I know you can't go out, but do something special inside. Maybe go old school and cook your wife a meal, candlelight and all. Families, do some stuff together as a family. Have some family game nights. do some crafts together. I realize I'm like the last person to talk about doing things as a family because we've got a newborn. Ben's 4 months old. But you know what I love doing is I love just wrestling with Ben. But make sure that you are doing some stuff as a family. Don't just mope around in the house or in different corners of your house, but utilize this time. Let this be a time that you look back on where your family grew together, was closer than they ever were, and you're loving each other. All right, church, I know that none of this is ideal, but and I know we've said this many times, but I mean it. My hope, my confidence is in the sovereignty of God. I know that Christ is Lord. I know that God is sovereign. Romans 8 says all things work together for the good of those who are called according to his purpose. And so we have to trust that this is part of God's good plan, whether it's, and there could be multiple aspects to it, by the way. It could be to cause this nation to repent of sin. It could be to cause us to realize that we've been investing in the wrong things. It could be to cause us to love the church and desire to be around each other. But church, let's glorify God, let's worship him, and while we're locked in our homes or outside in our front yard, let's long to give God glory.